There are lots of informational resources available to beekeepers, and those resources range in very basic things like how to keep bees to very complex topics, for example, instrumental insemination of queens. And you can also receive that information a lot of different ways. So in this video, I'm going to do my best to share with you some of the informational resources that exist and untangle some of the mess associated with where you can find good and reliable information. We'll start with people. One of the best ways to learn how to keep bees is just from other people. Have, for example, a mentor. Almost everyone who gets into beekeeping because they're aware of someone who keeps bees. They get connected with that someone, and that individual then serves as a mentor for that new and aspiring beekeeper. From there, I always recommend that beekeepers consider getting involved in a beekeeping club or association. Now, just like the organism that beekeepers keep, the honeybee, beekeepers are remarkably social and well-organized. There are local bee clubs in the U.S., there are state clubs, there are regional clubs, there's national associations, there's even international associations. Almost every country in the world has some sort of association linked to beekeeping. And as a beekeeper, you should really consider being involved in those, because not only do you meet other beekeepers, but you become aware of other resources that are available to you in your area. In a lot of areas around the world, there are also academic institutions associated with honeybees and beekeeping. Of course, I represent one of those at the University of Florida. In our particular case, we're a land-grant institution. In the United States, every state and territory has at least one land-grant institution, maybe more. And within those states and territories, there are local extension offices all over those states and territories. So as a beekeeper, you might be able to reach out to your local university expert about honeybees and beekeeping. If you don't have one, probably one of your neighboring states or neighboring regions or provinces, if you're outside the U.S., will have someone who's an expert in the field, maybe bringing more the science perspective about honeybees and beekeeping. And while we're talking about science in the U.S., at least, there's a number of governmental labs associated with keeping bees. We call these the USDA, or United States Department of Agriculture, research labs. There's a handful of bee labs scattered around the country, and each of them have their different specialties related to honeybees and beekeeping, and you can reach out to their scientists. And I know other countries have similar research programs at the governmental level, and those individuals often serve as a capacity expert for you. And while we're talking about government, let's branch out a little bit into the regulatory services that are often offered to beekeepers in the various states. In the U.S., again, as an example, we have state inspection programs, and the state bee inspectors, the local bee inspectors, all of these are wonderful folks with whom you can interact and learn a lot of information about honeybees and beekeeping. One area a lot of beekeepers don't consider an informational resource are actually the beekeeping equipment and supply companies, as well as the queen breeders and the nuke sellers and the packaged bee producers. All of these folks have a vested interest in you becoming beekeepers, so they're often very willing to answer questions that you may have. So again, thematically sticking with this idea about people, find people who know a lot about beekeeping, people who you can trust, people who've had years of successful experience, and they'll provide a lifetime of resource wealth for you in your beekeeping endeavors. Now let's segue to material resources available to you for your beekeeping. We'll start with books. I say the word book, very few people these days collect actual printed books, but when I was growing up, I read lots of books about beekeeping, and there's different types of books in our industry. For example, there are classic references to honeybees and beekeeping. For example, The Hive and the Honeybee, ABC and XYZ of beekeeping. Both of these are just reference books. They're not teaching you how to keep bees, but they have all sorts of information in them about the different types of bees and beekeeping equipment, honey production, and even honeybee anatomy and biology. They are worth owning. From there is also practical beekeeping books, books literally written to teach you how to put on personal protective equipment, how to build equipment, how to put bees in that equipment and take care of those bees as you're striving to get them productive and healthy. There are also scientifically themed books, books that don't really talk about the management of bees, but might introduce you to bee biology or ecology or swarming behavior or some other topic that you might find interesting. As we leave books, we move into periodicals. A lot of beekeeping associations around the world have newsletters where they're publishing their members' information and all sorts of resources. But I'm going to move instead from those newsletters, which are wonderful resources, to great country-level periodicals. For example, here in the U.S., we have the American Bee Journal, or Bee Culture periodicals that you can subscribe to and receive monthly, and there are similar periodicals for other countries that you can have access to if you live outside of the United States. And of course, we're moving into a very modern age where there's way more information available online than there ever has been. And this includes things, for example, websites. Our laboratory manages a website. All of these individual and people resources I mentioned to you, local bee clubs, state bee clubs, national, international bee clubs, all of these folks manage websites, and those can be great places for you to go. There are blogs about beekeeping, chat rooms about beekeeping, podcasts about beekeeping. In fact, our podcast is Two Bees in a Podcast. All of these are ways that people are trying to get information out to beekeepers. So you can read about bees, you can watch YouTube videos about bees, you can listen to podcasts about bees, you could interact with mentors and local bee clubs. There's more resources available these days about honeybees and beekeeping than there ever has been. The catch is, how do you filter all of that information to ensure that what you are receiving is actually good advice? Because there's lots of advice available in the general public sphere these days, but it's not all good. So one of the recommendations that I always give people, especially if you live in the U.S., is start with your land-grant universities. If you work at a land-grant university, like I do here at the University of Florida, you have an obligation to put out science-based information. We're not allowed to kind of dip into this idea of theory and opinion. What we put out has to be backed by science. So start kind of in those academic settings with information that you can trust. Also, consider what people are telling you. You know, a lot of people get very involved in social media, but it's not always a great place to find beekeeping. Go to people who you see have been very successful beekeepers for a very long period of time, are following ethical management practices, and those people are people you can trust. And if you ever have questions about a resource that you found but you wonder if it's considered reliable, you can always reach out to me and my team, and we'll do our best to steer you in the right direction. We have a wonderful resource guide where we go over lots of different resources available to beekeepers. So after you watch this video, make sure you check out the link that we provide in the closing credits so that you can find even more information about how you can find yet again more information about honeybees and beekeeping.